Okay. Yes, we have.
Oh my God, I don't have any idea or lesson last time because I'm absent. Can you teach me?
Yes, I can. Watch this video and help you a lot.
Really? Thank you so much.
Good day, everyone. I'll be discussing to you on how to find transfer functions of the system using Mason's rule. So first, what is transfer function? Transfer function is just defined by g of s is equal to c of s over r of s, or the ratio of the output over the input. I guess you already have an idea on how to reduce block diagrams to single transfer function. And now, we are ready to discuss a technique for reducing signal flow graphs to signal transfer function that relate the output of a system to its input. By the way, the block diagram reduction technique we study requires excessive application of fundamental relationships in order to arrive at the system. On the other hand, Mason's rule for reducing a signal flow graph to a signal transfer function requires the application of one formula. Hello everyone, so I'll be discussing to you the components of Mason's formula. So, Mason's formula has several components that must be evaluated first. So, we must be sure that the definition of the components are well understood. First, we have loop gain. So, what is a loop gain? So, it is the product of branch gains found by traversing a path that starts at a node and ends at the same node, following the direction of the signal flow without passing through any other node more than once. Here in the figure, we have four loop gains. We have G2S, H1S, G4S, H2S, G4S, G5S, H3S, and lastly, we have G4S, G6S, and H3S. So the next component is forward path gain. So what is a forward path gain? So it is a product of gains found by traversing a path from the input node to the output node of the signal flow graph in the direction of the signal flow. So there are two forward path gains in the figure. So we have G1S, G2S, G3S, G4S, G5S, and G7S. We have G1S, G2S, G3S, G4S, G6S, and G7S. So next is the non-touching loops. So what is the non-touching loops? So it is a loops that do not have any nodes in common. So in the figure, G2S, H1S does not touch loops with G4S and H2S. G2S and H1S does not touch loops also with G4S and G5S, H3S. And lastly, G2S and H1S does not touch loops with G4S, G6S, and H3S. And the last component of Mason's rule is the non-touching loop gain. So what is a non-touching loop gain? So it is the product of loop gains from non-touching loop gains taking 2, 3, 4, or 5, or more at a time. So in summary, all three of the non-touching loop gains taken two at a time in the figure are, we have G2S, H1S, and G4S, H2S. We have G2S, H1S, and G4S, G5S, H3S. And lastly, we have G2S, H1S, and G4S, G6S, H3S.
The transfer function C of S over R of S can be represented by this given equation. Where K is the number of forward paths, PK is a K and forward path gains. Then is equivalent to 1 minus summation of loop gains plus non-touching loop gains taken at a time. And lastly, delta K is equivalent to delta minus summation of loop gains in terms of delta that touch the forward path gain.
Since we already know how to find the transfer function using the formulas that was being discussed earlier, we are now going to solve the signal flow graph. First step, we need to find the forward path gain or FPG. FPG. We can see here that the forward path gain will through G1, G2, G3, G4, and G5S. So there is only one forward path gain in this signal flow graph. The second step is we need to find the loop gates. The loop gates here consists of three loop gates. First loop gain is G4 in H2S. Second is H3S in H1S. The third one is G2S, G3S, and H3S. The third step is we need to find the non-touching loop gates, rather, take it two at a time. So we are going to look at the loops. So we have three loops, loop 1, loop 2, loop 3. We can see that the non-touching loop gates, take it two at a time, is loop 1 and loop 2. Loop gates, loop 1 and loop 2. The second non-touching loop gate is the loop 1 and loop 3. Loop 1 and loop 3. The fourth step is we need to find the delta. There is a formula for finding the delta. The formula is delta is equal to 1 minus the summation of the loop gates, summation of loop gates, plus the summation of non-touching loop gates, taking 2 at a time. Since there is no non-touching loop gates, you take it 3 at a time. So delta is equal to 1 minus summation of all the loops, loop 1 plus loop 2 plus loop 3, because there is only 3 loops, minus and plus rather the non-touching loop gates. Then the delta is 1 minus G3S, H1S, G4S, and so on. The fifth step is the delta K. The formula of delta K is 1 minus the loop gain that does not touch the forward path gain. Since we can see here that all the loops are touching the forward path. So in our delta K, 1 minus 0. And finally, we are now on our last step, defining the transfer function. The formula is just the fraction of FPJ times the delta K over the delta. Our FPJ is this one, the first step, and our delta K is the fifth step, 1, and our delta is this one.
I learned a lot. Now I'm ready for the exam. Thank you. Thank you so much.